Christmas is just around the corner, and for sure, some of you have been thinking of adding the top gadgets of the year on your wish lists, especially smartphones. But in the recent years, gadget companies have become more competitive as they raise their specs at par with top-tier brands and at a significant fraction of the cost. That's why today, Lexi Schultz finds out why you should stop buying top-tier phones at a premium. Watch this.
The mobile phone market is a really unique animal. You'd think that tough times would allow people to consider the lower-end phones with the same capability as higher-end phones, but at a fraction of the price. But of course, the more popular phones are the ones that are more expensive. Why is that? Take a look.
This phenomenon is the call of a certain lifestyle. Though everyone has goals of their ideal lives, oftentimes, practicality flies out the window, especially when it comes to choosing a mobile phone. There's no denying the need for a mobile phone in the age of lightning speed communication and the need to be connected 24/7, but why go for the shiniest model when there are cheaper ones in the market that function the exact same way?
For some people, the high-end phones, the more expensive ones, actually is a status symbol. And then when people have it, they get a sense of fulfillment. So it's a sort of a small-scale achievement, like buying a brand new car or getting your first home. So having the latest and the greatest of smartphones for the year has some sort of a social impact as well, among friends, among colleagues.
Apart from seeing the phone as a status symbol, what allows major tech companies to charge big sums of money when smaller players can come up with the same basic functions for much less? According to Olandres, these big brands put a premium on top of the hardware specifications that they offer. Some of these premiums are capacity, speed, the amount of RAM, and screen resolution. Screen resolution in particular has become a growing trend this year. Some mobile phones with screens as small as 5.5 inches have twice the pixels when matched up against a 55-inch television. Camera capability is another important factor, especially with the advent of social media sites and the need to capture important points of people's lives. Whether it be a high-end or mid-range phone, another key feature is the rear camera and its capability to capture photos in low-light quality. However, Olandres says that 95% of the features or functionalities that you'd find in high-end phones are also available in mid-range phones. Still, people are willing to pay more for that added bonus. In fact, even color choice has become a premium in the smartphone market. Moving along to the actual price deficit, how wide a gap is there between high and mid-range phones? Thanks or no thanks to brand positioning, Olandres adds that once a phone is pegged anywhere below 30,000 pesos, it is no longer considered a premium handset. They have to actually position them against all the other competitors, despite the fact that there really is a huge margin. Mid-range phones, on the other hand, cost you about half of the high-end asking price, so you're looking at anywhere between 15 and 20,000 pesos. The challenge now is, how does one sway a consumer to choose the cheaper option?
The key here is to actually get the people experience. So pop-up booths and all that, a lot of concept stores, just to get the people to try out and see how the camera is, does it get hot a lot, how good the screen is. And overall, Filipinos are very touchy-feely type of consumers. They want to touch, they want to feel, they want to try it out before they can decide on buying it. So despite the digital age where a lot of consumer behavior is being dictated or influenced by online, at the end of the day, a lot of phones or flagship phones just become some sort of aspirational device that we know it's really nice, everybody wants to have it, but the budget is not there. You don't have the budget for it. So they often settle for the second best thing or a device that's really looks similar, comes from the same brand. That's a concept that a lot of vendors, phone vendors actually exploit. They offer really good, really nice flagship devices, and then like 3 months or 6 months in, they would introduce a smaller or a light version or a mini version. which would look like the same as the flagship, but actually a third of the price.
Now, before you run off to the gadget store, Olandres has one last tip to give you that would probably save you some money.
Basically, everyone who intends to buy a new phone or buys a smartphone for the very first time would need to ask themselves again, what would be their basic or the fundamental needs why they wanted a new phone? Is that browsing, accessing social media, making phone calls, doing messaging and all those group chats? And basically any smartphone at any price point is actually capable. And even the mid-range would last you 2 to 3 years if they come from a really good or reputable brand. So the others are just icing on the cake. They might look good, they might have they're more future-proof, they're way faster, but actually when you hold them, when you try them out, there's really not much difference between the two of them.
Now, is status a real reason to buy a mobile phone? If you're after particular functions, why not do your research and consider the lower-end phones? Not only will you get the same functions and capabilities of the higher-end phones, but you don't have to break the bank.